You're not listening, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
You're very ugly.
Mm-hmm.
You know what?
Yes. Baby, kabook. Kabook, I want it. I want. Kabook. You've been there with your man too, but this is not how you're supposed to react. You have to understand that men have their own limitations. Do not judge him by the norms and colors of your own perceptions. Yes, you're deep and so attached to your emotions. You can do 10 things at once in addition to another 10. Yes, you multitask. But his nature is different than yours. This animal runs on simple algorithms, manipulating which is not rocket science. Conditioning and reinforcements is all you need to master. Let's simplify. For this purpose, let's imagine that your man is a puppy. You love puppies, right? Who doesn't? They're so cute. So your puppy needs your love and nurture. Also, he needs a game to play and obstacles to overcome to grow. But also, if he poops in a place where it's not allowed, he needs to go through education not to repeat the same mistake again. You think it's stupid? Well, think again. You complain that he doesn't listen to you when he's doing something else. Well, it's a known fact, men cannot multitask. It's not because he doesn't care, it's just that the structure of our brain allows us to concentrate only on one thing at a time in order to manage that thing the best way we can. You know what, the reason is very simple. When you were hiding in your comfort cave some millions of years ago, he went hunting. And just imagine yourself a situation that you're
hunting rabbits.
And all of a sudden a huge bear appears from the woods, stands up straight, and roars into your face. What do you think? Your man will ask the bear, "Hey bro, just a second, I need to check in with my feelings. And I just bought new shoes and the shirt is from Prada." No, he must be fast, he must react. He shits his pants, escapes, or runs into attack. So don't blame him for the way the nature made him work. If you need his close attention, just wait until he finishes whatever he is doing and then call for his attention with your loving voice. And if he doesn't show interest in your stories or he seems not to care about the fact that you need to buy some baby powder for the child, don't rush to make a deal out of it either. As we said, he can concentrate on one thing at a time, and this simple limitation forces him to establish a system of prioritizations from most pressing issues with highest risks to the topics with no impact nor any perceivable benefit. This is why the story of your friend whose boyfriend left her in tears after a betrayal is the last thing that he will want to spend his time on. I understand, you want to share. You need to tell him everything. If you want his full and honest concentration, you must manipulate his mind by creating a benefit for him. For example, tell him, "Baby, I have a story to tell you and oh my god, I need your opinion." Or, "Honey, can you please come and help me to solve this and that." By putting in front of him a problem that requires his solution and by elevating the importance of his opinion, you're giving him an opportunity to show off and to be a problem solver. In its turn, labeling your story as a pressing issue with benefits for his man ego. And with baby powder, the story is short. You make him not forget to buy the pack by creating a cause and effect connection in his brain between lack of powder and the risks to health and comfort of his beloved offspring. Not always we can make such connection. So be the guy to make him understand and then he'll follow your demand. But yes, at times these efforts will fail, leaving you with just one option, the last one you want to use, a punishment of some kind. But don't be mean, don't be angry, and make sure that the punishment is well weighted and has a clear and firm relation to the behavior that you dislike. But on the other hand, when he is good and he listens, show your deep appreciation of his attention and his effort. Let him feel that he solved your problem right, that he is strong and he is smart. Nurture him with warmth and care, and he'll stand by you anytime and anywhere. And now, listen to me carefully. Stop dragging him every time, everywhere, with every endeavors of yours. let him be, and watch TV. Not every challenge that this life brings he succeeds to ditch or overcome with ease. And when his brain is overwhelmed with issues having no solutions, this produces excessive estrogen hormone in our body. And for us men, unlike you women, this increases irritation, frustration, and anger. So in order for him to reduce the stress, let him drift away and relax. Please, let him be. Like this video and subscribe to the channel. This was VM. See ya.